Hello everyone, welcome to the video series on Azure Backup for SAP HANA databases on Azure VM. My name is Pradeep Saran. I'm one of the product managers for business continuity and disaster recovery for databases. So the agenda that we have today is we want to cover insights into Azure Backup Service, and we're going to talk about some of the capabilities that we have around workload protection. And I'm going to give you a quick demo of SAP HANA Snapshot, SAP HANA Databases Snapshot capability, and we'll touch base on cost optimization and ransomware protection. So let's see how we protect the diverse set of workloads in Azure. So bottom up, if you can see the native workload integration that we have, Azure today supports wide variety of workloads, and we are constantly adding new workload support regularly. When we take a backup and then move the backup to the data plane, through secure channels, we use private endpoints, we use NSG, which is network security groups and Azure firewalls. And once the data gets moved to the data plane, it gets stored in multiple tiers. So we have the snapshot tier, which is basically used for when we snapshot the databases. And we have the standard tier where we store the regular backups. This standard tier is completely isolated from the customer tenants. And then we provide additional security elements to that. And we also introduce archival tier, which is basically used for long-term retention. And coming to the availability levels, we have LRS, ZRS, and RAGRS. And we also provide built-in security. We provide additional capabilities around RBAC, where you can give granular permissions to your admins. And we also provide encryption, where you can bring your own customer-managed keys and other capabilities around soft delete, MUA, which is multi-user authorization, and immutability, and so on and so forth. Now, moving on to the management plane, where you can basically configure, access, and manage all your backups in one single place. And we also provide that built-in management at scale view. So where you can see or manage your workloads across different vaults and different subscriptions as well. So let's see what we are doing for workload protection. So there are two options in terms of when you're trying to backup SAP HANA databases running in Azure VM. One is stream-based backup and the other one is snapshot-based backup. So let's get started with stream-based backup. So when backups are streamed out of the database engine and it's basically written to Azure managed storage, which is recovery services vault, we call it. And let's see what are the supported database versions and operating system versions that we have today. So we constantly certify with SUSE and RHEL versions as mentioned here. And in terms of supported deployment models, we support standalone Azure VMs, which is scale up and we don't support scale out. And in terms of HSR, which is your HANA system replication, which is a HA solution that predominantly one uses. So that solution is currently in public preview today. In terms of performance, we support 420 Mbps transfer rates. And some of the key callouts are, we support SSFS, which is secure storage file system, encrypted databases. And we also support SSL endforce on top of that. And coming to native client integration, we have support for HANA Studio and HANA Cockpit, predominantly most widely used tools by the SAP HANA admins. And we also have inbuilt mechanism to do some checks on the checksum, which basically increases the reliability of the backups. As you can see in the image, we take the intent from the customer in form of backup policy, and then we initiate the backup. And you can see there is an extension, backup extension, which gets installed on the Azure VM. We don't install anything on the database itself. And once we take the backup, we stream that backup to the recovery services vault here. So it's pretty straightforward and simple. And one other call out, which is unique differentiator for us, is we have a capability to understand and identify if there are any log chain breaks. So if there is a log chain break that's happening during backup, and if that goes missing, if you don't identify that, and during restore, your restore might not go through fine. And we all know the importance of downtime. It's going to be pretty expensive. And we have the unique capability to identify the log chain breaks. So what we also do after that is, once we identify, as part of a remedial action, we take a ad hoc backup or a backup, full backup, so that this can be avoided completely. And coming to the other call out, which is basically customers keep asking us, how do we manage support for newer operating systems or newer DB versions? So basically what we do is we do extensive sanity testing to understand if there are any performance issues with the newer operating systems. And once we are clear with that, we automatically update the backup extension. And there not be any impact to the databases that we are backing up. And moving on to the second option, which is snapshot-based backup. And as I said today, this solution is currently in public preview. And if you can see the image, so what we do with snapshot-based backup is once we initiate the backup, we freeze the database for a few seconds, and then we take the snapshot, and then we thaw the database, and then we are back to business. So what really happens is when the database is frozen just for seconds, so it's instead of the entire backup duration. So predominantly, this snapshot-based backup is recommended for large databases, anything beyond 6 to 8 terabytes. And obviously, these snapshot-based backups are highly cost-efficient as well. And I'm going to give you a demo of this end-to-end workflow of snapshot-based backup as well. And coming to another capability that we have is HSR support, which is HANA system replication support. This is specifically for stream-based backups. And also this solution is also in public preview as we speak. And with HSR, basically, if customers are using HA-based solution as HSR, one can leverage this integration. So with reference to HSR, there is no mandatory full backups that are required after takeover or failback, and unless otherwise there is a log chain break. And backups are automatically streamed to the current active database, to the Azure managed backup storage as well. And in terms of restore, a single chain backup basically will make the restorability simple and cost effective as well. So let's see a demo of snapshot-based capability for SAP HANA databases on Azure VM. So we get into the recovery services world. We can create the recovery services world and then do the discovery first. So we select SAP HANA as the workload. Then click on Discover. And we need to select the VM on which the databases are installed. Then we can get started. So while it's discovering, basically discover that, and then we can go ahead and initiate the backup. So there is a prerequisite today. Today, before taking a snapshot, we need to basically protect your backups. So that's why we are going to protect the databases using backend first, and then we'll come to snapshot capability. So the deployment is through. So let's get into configuring. So we've done the discovery now. We'll go ahead and do the backup configuration. So as I said, we'll start with the backend based protection. And then this is the backup policy. You can use the default or create a new one. Though we need to select the databases which you want to protect. So this is the VM that we discovered and the databases that we discovered. We select three databases. One is a systemdb, the other two are tenant databases. And then we can enable the backup. So once we are done with this, we will go ahead and enable the snapshot-based backup. So we'll get there, select SAP HANA. So we don't have to discover because we've done the discovery already, and we will do the snapshot-based backup. Again, I said, this is a public preview feature, and you can see the backup policies here. So we have the backup policies. Let's see what we have inside the backup policy. What are the different options? So we have the policy name, and we can select the frequency when you want to run this snapshot-based backup and the retention period. And we also have the resource group, and we also have a concept called managed identity. So when it comes to managed identity, basically we need permissions to take snapshots of the managed disks, and then when we place them in the resource group. So that's where we are taking managed identity is a layer of security again. So you can select what managed identity you need. Just wait for it to load, then select the managed identity. And the best part is once you add the databases, we can check if the managed identity which you had which you added has the privileges, required privileges. So you don't have to come out or wait for the backup to fail or something. So we automatically do some sort of pre-validation. So that way, you know, if the managed identity has the required roles. So in this case, we don't have. So what we do is we automatically assign those missing roles directly from this page. So you don't have to go out and then come back again. So that is a value add in terms of doing the validation of your managed identity. And then we can enable the backup. So as you can see, we backed up 3 databases and we also did a snapshot. So we also have a snapshot here and we can see how we can do an ad hoc backup as well. So you can click on backup now. So that way you also have an option to do kind of ad hoc backups if required. Now let's see what are the capabilities that we have in terms of restoring the backups. So we can first go ahead and restore the snapshot. Do the SAP SAP HANA. Then we should see the backup items. We can restore the snapshot. So if you can see a snapshot, we need to basically select the VM and also select the restore point. So there'll be multiple restore points based on your backup policy. We can select one of the restore points where you want to restore. And again, we have the concept of managed identity here as well. We validate this to make sure the managed identity user has enough roles and privileges. If not, we can automatically push them from here. And then finally, what we do is we attach and mount the snapshot. So on the target VM, once the validation is done, we attach and mount the snapshot on the target VM. So next step, what we can do is, if you're looking at point in time restore, we can restore the system database first. So this is basically, you've done the snapshot. We are basically doing logs on top of the snapshot. So here, if you can see, we need to select the point in time restore for logs. So this is for the system database. And once we restore that, we need to basically run a pre-registration script on the target VM and then restore the tenant databases. This is kind of a guidance from SAP. So basically that's why we do the system database first and then do the script. And then we go and restore the tenant databases. So now that we are done with the demo, let's see what we have for cost optimization. In terms of cost optimization, one can leverage pricing calculators, which provide granular item level view to understand what are your costs going to be. And we also provide support for reserved capacity. If you're getting into pre-committed usage, you get up to 24% savings on your backup costs. In terms of optimizing your costs, we also have capability around intelligent tiering, where during backup, you can see after a few months, move the backups to the archival tier for long-term retention. And then we automatically move those backups to the archival tier. And one can also leverage the backup reports so that these backup reports provide you great insights. And it'll also kind of show you patterns which can help right-size your backup storage as well. One can also clean up the backups to remove inactive or deleted data sources. So moving on to the reserved capacity I spoke about earlier. So in terms of reserved capacity, if you're getting into pre-commitment of 100 TB per month, for a year, we give you 12% discount. And for 3 years, we are giving you 20% discount. And if you're getting into 1 petabyte a month pre-commitment, you get 16% and 24% respectively. And in terms of the pre-commitment or the reserved capacity for Azure Backup, you can pay upfront or you can pay on a monthly basis at no additional cost. And you can use this for a single subscription or across multiple subscriptions as well. So let's see what we have for ransomware protection. So there's a capability called enhanced soft delete. So we had soft delete, and what this soft delete will do is basically protect your backups from accidental or malicious deletes. So if you delete your backups by mistake, we don't immediately delete them completely. So we move them to soft delete state, where we retain those backups for 7 days. So this was a capability we had for soft delete. So what we did is we came up with enhanced soft delete, where we store that or retain those backups for 14 days before permanently deleting them. And then you can basically configure the retention period. And during the retention period, which is by default 14 days, we don't charge the customer. And then anything goes beyond the 14-day period, you may incur additional charges. So the options that we have in terms of enhanced soft delete, we have disable, enable, and always on enable. And this is a vault level setting that you can use today. And again, this is a public preview feature that we have. We already have the soft delete capability, and enhanced soft delete is currently in public preview. And coming to immutability, right? So immutability is basically a vault level setting again. So once you create a recovery point, so it cannot be deleted or its retention period cannot be reduced, right? So it could be some malicious actor in your own organization who's trying to delete or reduce the backup retention period. So that's the use case of having this immutability feature. And this is again a vault level setting for recovery services vault and backup vault. So what is permitted here is you can go ahead and still stop the protection and retain data. And what we don't allow is you cannot stop and delete the data. So we stop that delete operation completely once you enable the immutable vault. And what is also permitted is you can edit and change the backup policy to increase the retention period, but you cannot decrease the retention period. So these are some of the restrictions that comes along with the feature itself. And we also have modern air gap. So basically this talks about the recovery services vault capability that we have. So traditionally, if you take air gap solutions where there not be no network connectivity, or data will be completely isolated and offline. So when it comes to recovery services world, we leverage modern air gap capabilities where it's secure network, we connect to secure network, and we also have the data which is isolated and online as well. So if you can see, we use various mechanisms to do this. One is we enforce MFA, which is multi-factor authentication, and we also provide granular RBAC capabilities. And we also have MUA, which is multi-user authorization. And we also bring in capability of private endpoints, where if you're transferring your backups from your source data source to the target VM or your recovery services vault, one can leverage private endpoints as well. And on top of that, we also provide security alerts to monitor all this. These are overview of what are the new capabilities that's available in BCDR today. And this pretty much covers about Azure VM, SQL VM, SAP HANA, and what we are doing in terms of security and backup center as well. And here are some of our resources which you can go in and understand more about Azure BCDR capability. And that's all we had in this video series. Looking forward to meeting you all in the next one. Thank you.